Well, welcome to another opportunity to worship online with the community of faith of Alamance Lutheran Church. Hi, I'm Pastor Ron Philibom. You know, God's word is like the rain that we're about to receive. And that rain, it waters the earth and brings forth vegetation. It also is like the sower who scatters seed indiscriminately. Our lives are like seeds sown in the earth, even from what appears to be little and dormant or dead. God promises a harvest. At the Lord's table, we are fed with the bread of the table, and it's the bread of life, that we may bear fruit in the world. So come along with us as we learn and grow together. Come on. Please bow your heads with me in prayer as we come before our Lord and Savior and quiet our hearts and minds. Lord, let the words of my mouth and the meditation of my heart be acceptable to you, our Lord, our rock, and our Redeemer. Amen. Well, some of you grew up in hard times. You did whatever you had to do to make ends meet, and even then there was nothing much left to stretch, so you went without. That is lost, I'm afraid, with the easy access to credit these days. My mom and dad, they went through the Depression as children. I heard stories from my grandparents how they savored food for a long time, but they also savored life. Dolly Parton sings about how struggle made her siblings and her mom and dad stronger. Jesus informs the disciples that their life will not be easy peasy, but they will produce good fruit. We often forget that a seed planted like this garden here goes through quite a transformation from a dry, simple, piddly little thing through proper nourishment and the sun, of course, and the rain. It breaks above the soil and transforms into something really special. Well, here in North Carolina, we have a beautiful mountain, especially if you're going south on I-77, and it's iconic. You see this giant mountain rise. It's called Pilot Mountain. And if you go up to Pilot Mountain, you can see it. You can drive to the very top and hike around this impressive site. On your screen right now, you'll see a picture, and it's one that I took on a day where I was just struck how this impressive tree grew under such harsh conditions. Yet, it did. Well, the kingdom of God was the main emphasis of Jesus's ministry. And this is accepted by most. But defining precisely what the kingdom was is a bit more difficult. Indeed, even Jesus himself was often elusive about it. He did not speak in absolutes, rather he spoke in parables, such as our scripture text for this morning. Jesus compared the kingdom to a sower going out and spreading seed. Some of it falls upon hard ground and is unable to take root. Some of it falls on shallow ground, and although it initially sprouts, it later withers away. But some seed, it falls upon good earth, and it comes to fruition and produces a harvest. Well, like that tree you see on your screen on Pilot Mountain. We are to understand, of course, that the sower is God, the seed is the kingdom, and the various types of soil represents us, you and me. On the surface of it, of course, it doesn't sound as though God is a very frugal farmer. After all, most of the seed that is strewn about never takes root. But this is not really a story about the sower or the seed. It is a story about different types of soil, or to put it another way, the responses of different types of people in the kingdom. The question is really, what is the state of our hearts when the seeds are sown within us? See, the stories Jesus tells are not subject to our control. He tells these stories so that we can be transformed. He tells these stories not so that we can ask questions about them, but so that the stories can ask questions about us. We are seed planters and we are seed nourishers. We are seed growers. We all play a part in transforming these seeds when we yield to the guidance and direction of the Holy Spirit. We just happen to be located on a hill here at Alamance Lutheran Church. And like that tree on the top of Pilot Mountain, I wonder what trees we will build together with the seeds that God has entrusted us with. Amen.